State Senator Gustavo Rivera on January 11th. Our first January 11th of 2022. Happy New Year. Welcome everyone back. I am joined by many of my colleagues, the ranking member of the Health Committee, Senator Gallivan, also Senator Brook, Senator May, Senator Biaggi, Senator Steck, Senator Hoylman, and Senator Overacker, as well as by my staff, including Mary Storace, my legislative assistant, as well as Tony Kergaravat, who is the new committee director. Welcome you, Tony. So I'll just take a second. Senator Steck, if you could mute yourself, sir. Senator Kaminsky. Yeah, no worries. And Senator Kaminsky, who is not on video but is with us. I'll just take a second to acknowledge, thank everyone for reaching out. For folks who see this in the future, it is now January 11th, 2022, only 2 days removed from a horrific fire that happened in my district at 181st Street, just a few blocks from my district office, where as of today, 17 people have lost their lives. It is obviously it's kind of taken up a lot of, a lot of folks have reached out both from across the aisle, across the state, and across the country. Even some folks who have established relationships over the years in other states have reached out. It is obviously a big tragedy. We're I'm up in Albany right now, but my staff is, along with the staff of the local council member, assembly member, congress member, borough president, mayor. It's an all hands on deck approach because that's how much need is happening right now. I certainly will go on the record and thank you, Senator Overacker, for reminding me of this, of thanking the men and women of the Fire Department of New York who so bravely went into this fire and averted further catastrophe. And we will certainly have much to talk about in the next couple of months about it, potentially legislatively, but for the moment, our condolences to all family members and community members, and we will be doing as much as we can to make sure that we can provide for those families. And thank you, Senator Ryan, for joining us as well. So this is the first agenda for the year 2022. We have many bills which we've moved in the past in the Senate, and hoping that we get a little bit more movement this year, but we'll just kick it off with the Senate Bill 48484A from Senator Krueger.
An act to amend the public health law and the civil rights law in relation to prohibiting the making and or broadcasting of visual images and of individuals undergoing medical treatment without prior written consent.
We've passed this bill in the past. Relates to a situation in Senator Krueger's district of a person's whose death was filmed and screened on a reality show. And there's great issues with privacy, even though the face was obscured, the voice was not, the family members were quite upset, etc. So this would establish a right to privacy in that type of treatment so that it is not broadcast. Any questions or comments about this bill? All right, do I have a motion? Senator Biaggi moves it, Senator May seconds. All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? That bill is moved. Yes, it's moved to first reading. Next bill by me, Senate Bill 1172B.
An act to amend the public health law in relation to the provision of informed consent.
And that one we've moved in the past as well. It updates patient's bill of rights on informed consent. Do we have any questions or comments on this bill? All right, do I have a motion? See a motion by Senator Hoylman, seconded by Senator Brook. All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? Without rec. And that bill goes to first reading. Next by Senator Sanders, Senate Bill 1374.
An act to amend the public health law in relation to collaborative models for addressing healthcare disparities.
So this is collaboration programs already exist in law. This would be more specific to make sure that those collaborative programs include ways to address disparities, healthcare disparities in particular communities across the state. We have passed it in the Senate before. Do I have any questions or comments on this bill? Seeing none, do I have a motion? See a motion by Senator Biagi, seconded by Senator May. All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? That was support, right, Brooke? Okay. Without rec. And that bill goes to first reading. Next bill, if it's reported out of this committee, would be referred to finance by me, Senate Bill 1411A.
An act to amend the social services law in relation to extending the Medicaid coverage period for pregnancy.
We have passed this bill before. It is the shorthand for is the fourth trimester bill, and it would extend coverage for postpartum for birthing people from 60 day to 1 year. And we want to make sure that we get that done, hopefully this year. Do I have any questions or comments on this bill? Senator Brooke.
I just want to commend you again, Chairman, for bringing this bill. I think it's something that's incredibly important for birthing people across New York and across the country. I hope more people take note of what we're doing here. This is something that's not only going to help the person who is birthing, but also the children that they're birthing to be able to have that support well beyond, as you call, the fourth trimester. That is really the time when a lot of that support falls off and is going to exponentially increase health outcomes. And I think it's important and has my full support. And I hope that we're able to get it over the finish line this year. So thank you.
Absolutely. Thank you, Senator Brew, for that. Thank you, Senator Thomas, for joining us, by the way. Do I have any further questions or comments on this bill? Seeing none, I figure I have a motion for Senator Brooke to move it and a second from Senator Hoylman. All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? Without rec. And that bill moved to finance. Next bill, if reported out of this committee, would move to first reading by me, Senate Bill 1578A.
An act to amend the social services law in relation to including applied behavioral analysis under standard coverage for Medicaid recipients.
We've passed it in the Senate in the past, pretty self-explanatory, including applied behavioral analysis for the treatment of autism spectrum disorders. Do you have any questions or comments on this bill? Seeing none, do I have a motion? See a motion for Senator Biagi, seconded by Senator May. All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? Without rec. And that bill goes to first reading. Next bill, Senate Bill 2542A by me, it would go to first reading if reported out of this committee.
An act to amend the social services law in relation to the determination of eligibility for medical assistance benefits.
It's one of a series of bills. We actually passed it out of the Senate last year. It's a series of bills in response to the Departed's Medicaid redesign team. It's what I call the former governor, the Departed. Some changes that we believe were unnecessarily established in the MRT. This one relates to a look back period for determination of eligibility. So any questions or comments on this bill? Seeing none, do I have a motion? I see Senator Biagi, seconded by Senator Thomas. All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? Without rec. And that bill goes to first reading. Next bill, if reported of this committee, would go to finance. That is 2543 by me. Go ahead.
An act to amend the public health law in relation to payments for personal protective equipment for home and community-based long-term care services.
So we got it to finance last year. Hopefully we can get it all the way passed and potentially passed in the assembly. And it refers to making sure that we can get workers reimbursed for their expenses in PPEs and personal protective equipment. Hopefully we were able to do that. Do I have any questions or comments on this bill? Yes, Senator May.
Yeah, I'd just like to make a comment about the hearing that we held last summer about the long-term care workforce and people who testified, one woman in particular who testified about being sent to a home where she wasn't told the people in that home had COVID, and she wasn't provided with protective equipment, and she ended up catching COVID and being out for at least 6 months, very ill, but also out of a job for all of that time because of her illness. And it just really brought home the need for this. So thank you for this bill, and on behalf of the all the workers we heard from and the many, many others that we didn't hear from who really need this. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator May, and thank you for reminding us not only of that hearing, but of the efforts that we are making, and hopefully with the help of this new administration will make in the budget season, as well as the rest of the year, around workforce issues, which we know are incredibly serious and will only get more so if we don't make a real investment. So thank you for that, Senator May. Any other questions or comments on this bill? Seeing none, I figure that Senator May would move it. Do I have a motion from Senator May, second by Senator Biaggi? All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? Opposed? Steck or opposed?
Without rec, sorry.
Without rec, that was going to go there.
I got ahead of myself.
Without, no worries. Without rec, I have Senator Steck, I have Senator Gallivan, I have Senator Oberacker. And that bill, thank you, gentlemen, that bill is moved to finance. Next bill by Senator Kennedy, Senate Bill 38666, if reported in this committee, would go to first reading.
An act to amend the public health law in Chapter 802 of the laws of 1947, relating to facilitating the financing and effectuation of air terminals by the Port of Newark Authority in relation to requiring certain lactation accommodations in airports.
This is something we've passed in the Senate before. I know it's a priority for Senator Kennedy, and we're hoping to get it over the finish line this year, related to the establishment of lactation rooms in airports. Do we have any questions or comments on this bill? And seeing none, do I have a motion? I have a motion for Senator Biaggi, second by Senator Brook. All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? Without rec? And that bill moves to first reading. Next, by Senator Reichlin Melnick, it would be reported to first reading, Senate Bill 3966A.
An act to amend the public health law and the social services law in relation to children's non-regulated camps.
This one relates to people potentially being on the sex advised on the sex offender registry and the requirement of these types of camps to make sure that they will be required to ascertain if an employer or employee or volunteer is on a sex offender registry. Do I have any questions or comments on this bill? Seeing none, do I have a motion? I have a motion for Senator Biaggi, seconded by, I'm gonna say Senator Thomas. Senator Thomas, all those in favor? Aye. Opposed? Without rec? And that bill goes to first reading. Next, by me, Senate Bill 4965, and it would go to first reading.
An act to amend the public health law and the social services law in relation to automatic enrollment and recertification simplification for Medicaid eligible recipients.
We also passed it in the Senate, pretty self-explanatory, related to how we go about the recertification process of people on Medicaid. Want to make sure that we can facilitate that process for folks who find themselves in the situation where they have to recertify. We want to make that process easier. Any questions or comments on this bill? Right. Do I have a motion? I see a motion from Senator Hoylman, seconded by Senator Biaggi. All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? All right. I see Senator Oberacker, Senator Steck, opposed. Without rec, Senator Gallivan, without rec, that bill is moved to first reading. And I believe this is the last bill, but certainly not least, by Senator Mannion, Senate Bill 7023, it would go to first reading.
An act directing the Commissioner of Health to conduct a study on the rates of reimbursement made through the New York State Medicaid Durable Medical Equipment Orthotics, Prosthetics, and Supplies Program for rate adequacy and patient access, and providing for the repeal of such provisions upon expiration thereof.
pretty self-explanatory, establishing a study to that relates to the reimbursement rates for all of the above mentioned medical stuff, if you will, and rate accuracy, therefore. Do I have any questions or comments on this bill? Right, do I have a motion? See, motion by Senator Hoylman, second by Senator May. All those in favor, aye. Opposed, without rec. And that bill goes to first reading, and that is the first meeting of the year. Thank you, everyone, and I will see you soon.